It's kind of charming and humbling when a famous actor makes a faux pas, tripping on the red carpet, a bit of food in their teeth, or getting into a fender bender. It helps us remember that these glitzy stars are just real people deep down, but then sometimes it goes way too far. And it's the opposite of charming when they show their humanity by dropping to the lowest common denominator and committing truly horrible crimes. I mean, these are the people we looked up to, and the betrayal is even worse when it's a sitcom star, because they were the most wholesome people on the telly. I'm Nostalgic Nick with Do You Remember? And today we're taking a look at some 1970s sitcom stars accused of some terrible crimes. Don't forget to give this episode a thumbs up for us and subscribe to the channel for more throwback fare. Whether it was attempted murder, rampant sexual assault, or just some good old-fashioned tax fraud, all of these stars were up to no good in the disco decade. So let's dance. Robert Wagner. With hits with detective shows like Switch and Heart to Heart, no one could pretend to solve crimes in the 70s quite like Robert Wagner. But unfortunately, none of his on-screen personas were able to investigate the mysterious 1981 drowning of his wife, Natalie Wood. Or we might have had some more answers than we do. What we do know is that after a night of drinking on their sailboat with Christopher Walken, Wagner and Wood got into a loud argument, and Wood was later found in the ocean with bruises and abrasions on her body. Initially acquitted of any wrongdoing, in 2018, the Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department named Wagner a person of interest and reopened the investigation, but still no charges have been filed. Bob Crane. In the late 60s and early 70s, Bob Crane starred as the eponymous colonel on the hit sitcom Hogan's Heroes, in which wily American POWs outsmart bumbling Nazis. And Crane was charming and charismatic, and audiences loved him, which made it even more shocking when he was found bludgeoned to death in his apartment in 1978. And the sordid details that emerged from the investigation into his murder cast Crane in a completely new light. It turned out that for years, Crane and an associate named John Henry Carpenter had filmed their sexual encounters with women without their knowledge, and Crane kept an extensive library of these creepy, voyeuristic crimes in his home. Carpenter was tried, but eventually acquitted of the murder, and still today, the crime remains officially unsolved. Bill Cosby, a man who needs no introduction, quite possibly the biggest sitcom star of the 70s and 80s, and purveyor of all things Jell-O. Of course, I'm talking about the legendary comic and apparently really awful dude Bill Cosby. Cosby began his legendary career as a comic in the 60s, before going on to conquer TV during the next decade with his first sitcom, The Bill Cosby Show, and the animated hit Fat Albert and the Cosby Kids. And Bill would famously go on to produce and star in the number one sitcom in America, the 80s smash hit The Cosby Show. But it all came crashing down for the sweater-wearing funny man when in 2014, numerous allegations of sexual misconduct and rape began to surface. To date, over 60 women spanning more than 40 years have come forward to accuse the comedian of rape or sexual harassment, and the once wholesome pinnacle of sitcom fame has come falling rapidly back to earth. Todd Bridges. Starting in 1978, Different Strokes was one of the most popular and poignant sitcoms in America. The show was famous for its special episodes that would confront such deep topics as racism, alcoholism, and even child sexual abuse. And it made stars out of its three young actors, including the show's only surviving original cast member, Todd Bridges. On Different Strokes, Bridges charmed audiences as Willis Jackson, the older brother of Gary Coleman. But unfortunately, the pressure of becoming so famous at a young age, combined with both physical and mental abuse, led the young Bridges down a dark path. He was soon abusing both crack and meth, and in 1989 was arrested in the shooting death of a Los Angeles drug dealer. However, Bridges was represented by high-powered attorney Johnny Cochran, and was soon acquitted of all charges. So I guess the glove didn't fit. Alan Alda. Alan Alda was the beating heart of MASH, the immensely popular 1970s sitcom that used the Korean War as a setting to help America come to grips with the reality of the war in Vietnam. which made it so surprising when Alda was accused of... No, I'm just kidding. The only thing Alda has been accused of is being an absolute gem of a human being. But I figured we could use some good news in the middle of this list. And honestly, I wanted to see if you're still paying attention. So toast to Alan, cause he's a delight. Mackenzie Phillips. In the mid-70s, Mackenzie Phillips was on top of the world. She was the star of one of TV's most popular sitcoms, One Day at a Time, for which she earned almost $250,000 a week in today's money, and had the world at her feet. But the good times were not going to last, and unfortunately, Phillips had been exposed to a rock and roll lifestyle from a very young age. Her father was John Phillips of Mama's and the Papa's fame, and she began abusing drugs at a young age. And this caught up with her, and after two near-fatal overdoses, she was fired from the show that made her famous. And after her father's death, Mackenzie told the world about her dark secret, that when she was 19 and on the night of her wedding, she remembers coming out of an alcohol-induced blackout while having sex with her father. A pregnancy and abortion followed, which finally terminated a nearly decade-long illegal incestual relationship between Mackenzie and her father. Paul Lynde. The man so funny, Mel Brooks once described him as being able to get people to laugh by reading a phone book, tornado alert, or a seed catalog. As Uncle Arthur on the 70s sitcom Bewitched, and the longtime Center Square on Hollywood Squares, Paul seduced the nation with a combination of wit and charm rarely seen on TV. But behind the scenes, all was not well. Lynde was secretly gay, and fears that his career would end if he were outed led to him abusing alcohol in order to cope. He would often fly into a rage, lashing out at anyone and everyone around him. Then, one night in 1965, Lynde and a young 24-year-old lover were drinking in a hotel room all night, when, after a little horsing around, the young actor fell 8 stories out the window to his death. And while Lynde was never formally charged, the comedian whose drunken, violent rages were commonplace was always suspected of a bit of foul play. Find out more about this, like how it was kept from the papers, in our Paul Lynde bio episode. Red Fox. As the bigoted and irascible Fred Sanford on the hit show Sanford and Son, Red Fox wowed audiences every week with his mean zingers and zany hijinks, often including faking a heart attack or arthritis, you know, to get out of doing any kind of work. The show made Fox into one of the biggest stars in America, and at one point he was making over $4 million a year. Unfortunately, Fox had terrible management, and his fortune was soon drained away. The fact that, while not a crime, is very silly. But what is a crime, however, is not paying taxes on all of that income. And quickly, Fox was in hot water with the IRS. In 1983, the government issued liens against the comedian totaling over $750,000. And due to his management's incompetence, Red Fox had no way to pay it. It was estimated that at the time of his death in 1992, he still owed the IRS over $3 million. But hey, you can't take it with you, right? John Travolta. And an honorable mention goes out to John Travolta, who got his start as Vinnie Barbarino, the unofficial leader of the Sweat Hogs on the classic 70s show Welcome Back, Kotter. And while Travolta has never been accused of an actual crime, he did fund, produce, and star in the epically horrific Battlefield Earth. Perhaps the worst movie of all time, and such a travesty that all involved do deserve some sort of gruesome punishment. Anyone who has seen it would agree. There they are, some of the biggest sitcom stars of the 70s who were accused of some terrible stuff. So, you're the jury, let's talk. Who do you think was guilty? And who is innocent? Alan Alda definitely guilty of being fantastic, but I don't have so much hope for Bill Cosby. Did we miss a famous 70s sitcom star with some skeletons in their closet? Please add them in the comments below. We read them all. And if you enjoyed our rundown, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel so you never miss a memory. From all of us here at Do You Remember, thanks very much for watching, and stay out of trouble, y'all.